impacted my life because he walks the walk, and seeing him lead and serve has caused me to strive to do the same thing.
I want to say thank you, Coach Hall, for letting me be a part of the team. Even though I was plagued with injury this year, I also want to thank you for developing me as a man.
Hey, what's up, Coach Hall? I just want to say thank you for a great season, and just thank you for being a great coach for me, and just pushing me to do my best, you know, through tough times and good times, just being there with me and pushing me, and I really appreciate that, and it's a blessing to be your player and have you as a coach, and just thank you so much for the lessons you've taught me, and how to be a man, and I just really appreciate it, and the opportunity I had to play for you meant a lot, and I appreciate it. Thank you, Coach.
Hey, Coach Hall, this is Darius. You've impacted my life so much in this 1 year. From the recruiting process to when I got there my freshman year of college, you helped me through a lot. And a lot, not only on the court, but off the court as well. I just wish nothing for the best, but just nothing but the best for you in your future and for your family as well, because those kids, I literally treat them just like my younger siblings, and they're literally like family to me. I want to say thank you for letting me have the opportunity to play college basketball. That means so much to me in so many ways. Thank you so very much.
How you doing, Coach Hall? Bit Maher checking in. Man, I just want to let you know, you really helped me throughout my season, helping me with my confidence, telling me, just pushing me, helping me become a better person, just all, like, helped me when I got home, like, showing my brother them what the perfect thing to do and like things like that. Like if I never came to TSC, like my character and things like that, it just would have never been the same. Like I just would have been the same person. Like I wouldn't have escalated going up. So I just want to say thank you for all the things you did and the opportunity to play for you. It was quite an experience. And thank you for all the things you've done for me. Bit Maher checking out.
Coach Hall, there's a lot of great things I can say about him, but I'm gonna just say a few. He was a great coach, and I was glad to have him. This is my first year coach, and he taught me a lot. He taught me how to be confident through everything. He taught me how to give my all and how to fully use my potential, and I'm gonna just think of the stuff that he told me to do over the summers, you know, to become a better player for next season. And I'm really gonna miss him, so.
Hey, Coach Hall, I don't know what all to say, because if I said everything that you've done for me, this video could go on for days. But I do wanna tell you what's on my heart from the beginning. You know, I wouldn't have ended up at Toccoa Falls if it wasn't for you and your willingness to care about me and check on me when I went through that car wreck, and that really shows your true character, and I thank you for that. I also thank you for teaching me how to be different and living my life differently from everyone else. We had that one talk in your office about Moses, and you know, maybe not always taking the easy route, but taking the route that's different and standing out, and I thank you for that. You're the person who taught me that. I just thank you for all the laughs and the cries and everything that we've been through. I really thank you for that. You're a true godly man, and everything that you've shown me, I can't thank you enough. And to Miss Jamie, you've shown me how to be a great woman. You are a true inspiration to me and all the girls on the team, and we thank you for that. Coach Hall, well, let's just say you can't outshoot me, but you can run faster than me, so that's something. I wish y'all the best, and thank you for everything. I love you guys. Thanks.
If it weren't for Coach Hall, I probably wouldn't even been at Toccoa Falls. Like, I built a relationship with him, and like, without Coach Hall, my life probably wouldn't even be the same. I was going down a very bad path, and Coach Hall just took me in like I was his own. You know, you don't meet too many people like that who care about you just more than basketball. Like, you care about you as a person, as a human being. He can care less about basketball, but he will help you get better though.
So I'm very glad I was able to meet Coach Hall and have a person like Coach Hall in my life.
Hey, Coach Hall, so I just want to take a minute and thank you for everything that you've done these past couple years for not only the girls basketball team, but also for the athletic department in general. I just want to tell you that, you know, you were one of the biggest reasons I decided to play basketball at TFC to begin with. And I mean, that's just been one of the greatest decisions I've ever made. And so it's really just because of your great ability to connect with people, not only just basketball players, but just people in general, and really get to know them for who they are and get to help them in their spiritual walk. And I really appreciated that. And I really loved how prioritized that was within our team that first year. I think that was amazing, and I'd never really seen that from any other teams or coaches that I've ever been on. And so I just want to thank you for that, and thank you for everything that you'll do in the future, and thank you for all the hard work that you put in this year as well.
Coach Hall has impacted me by showing me that the game of basketball is more than basketball. It's love at TFC. Like, basketball is what made us, that's what made us closer as a team. Like, we love that sport. And now I got a group of brothers, I can say that's my family, and they can support me. And when I'm down, they can be there to help me up. And the five core values, those are just stuck in my head. Like, faith, character, positive vibes, servant leadership. Like, it just stuck in my mind. And I know you, for the players, if we wanted to talk to coach, only thing you had to do was just talk to him. Like, he'll understand, he'll give you advice back. And if you want to put work in, and he also showed me that, if you put more work in, your confidence is going to come. It's going to come sometime. And just because he was a great father, and I remember talking to him on the bus. I was talking about how I want to be this guy in the future, being able to provide for my family and stuff, and just be a great father. And that's because of Coach. Coach, you did a lot. You had your family in the gym while you was coaching. And you just did a lot. And man, you just a great guy, no cap. You still a great guy. But you just all love over there, man. I love you, Coach.
Hey, Coach Hall. This is not my comfort zone. And I could probably ramble for an hour. But I don't want to keep you here forever, so I'll just talk. I just want to say thank you. Thank you for everything you've done. Thank you for showing me what a Christ-driven father is. And allowing me to see that as you show me that through Jamie and the kids and just the way you teach and you lead. And I can take that and say, this is what I want for my kids, and this is what I want for my husband. So I thank you for that, and I thank you for showing me what that is, because I never had it growing up. So I really, truly appreciate that. And we've been through a lot, me, you, Jamie, the kids, from sophomore year to senior year. And I know God had a plan for that, and I know that everything works for his good, so I can only imagine what the future has and for you guys, and I'm so excited for that. And I want to say thank you lastly for giving me someone to trust again, 100% trust. I mean, outside of Austin, I don't take it lightly, and so I thank you for allowing me to open up and be true to myself and true to you and just real, and it's nice to have someone like that. And thank you for all you've done with basketball. I mean, you've definitely used it as a tool to teach not only this game, but what Christ has for us in that game. And you've been an awesome teacher, awesome coach, an awesome leader, and I love you. And yeah, that's all I got. So I got more, but you know. Bye Chapman. Bye, Coach. Bye, Jamie. Bye, kids. Love you all.
Hey, Coach. I bet Chap is kind of surprising you with this. But yeah, you've impacted me in a lot of different ways. I think probably the biggest ways have been with the example that you've set. The way that the generosity that you have is pretty amazing. I mean, letting myself and two other people stay in your basement is a huge help to us. And I think it just shows you being willing to give up space and time and things like that. So just your generosity. I think the intentionality with fun that really impacts people, like the whole pieing thing, and even just inside jokes, like a tap on the shoulder thing or whatever else. I think those are really cool ways to just be intentional and show love on people while having fun, which you always pursue fun. And so I know that's something I've witnessed and taken away from you as well. I think some of the examples that you've set with your family, I know you had, like, you let me come in and pray with you guys on the one night, and I think that's just a cool example of something that I think I'm probably gonna do with my kids when I have them. So that was really cool that to be invited into that. Let's see, I could keep going on. I know, obviously, from a basketball standpoint, I'm a lot smarter and better basketball player because of you, playing under you for 3 years. So I know that's gonna be really beneficial whatever that looks like in terms of if I'm coaching kids or, and I don't know, playing ball with Muslim youth somewhere or something like that. So that's been really big. I think it's really cool too, like even seeing like the little cards that you wrote for everyone, just again, more examples of ways to encourage and love on people. Work ethic too. You've shown me what work ethic can look like. And so I just think of even that first year or first 2 years really, when you coached both teams, had your whole family. I mean, I guess that first year Cruzy would have been like a year or something like that. So just the work ethic and drive and all of that. So you've just been a big example in a lot of different ways of like just some good pictures of how I can be as a man. So yeah, you impacted me quite a bit. So thank you, love you, coach. I'm curious to hear what happens with Florida and where family goes. So bye.
What's going on, coach? I hope everything's going well up there at Tacoa. Hope everybody's staying safe, staying in the house. But I just want to say thank you for doing everything that you've done for me my first 2 years at Tacoa. You guided me throughout the way. You made sure I was good. You did everything for me. You treated me like I was family, and I appreciate that. And I just pray that everything works out for everybody, and you just continue being the man that you've always been, coach. And I appreciate you.
I just want to say that I am so very thankful that I've gotten to know you throughout the years. I know that God led me to TFC, and you were a big part of that. Right when I came to TFC, I noticed the authenticity of you, just meeting your family, how you were with them, just the type of person you are. It's amazing. And just how you've impacted my life, along with everybody that you've coached. You've been a great role model throughout the years, a great coach, a great friend. I remember the first thing that really stood out to me was my first season there. I tore my ACL, and immediately, right whenever I was down, you were by my side praying over me, and I'll never forget that. That really impacted my life. And just throughout the struggles, throughout the years, just seeing your faith and seeing how you haven't wavered in that. You've been so faithful to God, and the way you impact the team through that, you really encourage us in our faith and relate basketball to how we can glorify God through that. That's one thing that I will carry throughout the rest of my life. I've never had a coach like that. It's always just been like basketball. But with you, you've shown us that basketball is our platform to glorify God. And so I really think that's huge. And I'm so very grateful for that, because that's something that will turn into impacting others, which I think is amazing. So, and that's just one example of your character and your faithfulness to God. So I thank you for that. And you as a coach, you've been great. I missed playing for you last year. I remember my freshman year, you had us go on the line one after the other. I was like, this guy is crazy. Like, maybe I'm not cut out for this. But that's, you really pushed us because you cared for us. And that was really evident throughout that season. And it's just been an honor to be around you in the office, on the court, it's just an honor to know you and joke around with you. So I'm very thankful for our friendship.
Coach Hall, no idea how I'm about to try to do this in just 1 to 2 minutes, but I'll give it my best shot. Over our relationship together, just trying to think through the cornerstone moments that obviously all started with intramural, my junior year, playing against you and getting to know you and meeting a person that was incredibly competitive, but their love for Jesus genuinely shone through it. That was something that I was able to connect with, and then finding out that you were to be the coach next year. I've told you this before, but it was a God orchestrated thing, because I had been at peace with not playing basketball in college, and I knew that's why I wasn't at Tacoma Falls. But being able to come back, play the sport I love, and do it for the glory of the Lord, and building a culture with you, even though to the world, you know, we took part in something that to the world didn't look successful, but I'll cherish those memories always. And I know that what you and I did that year, even if we never see it, will pay dividends. And it's something that I wouldn't trade for the world. It grew me as a man, and you've become a spiritual role model for me for all time, and someone who played a huge part in my chapters at TFC. And you poured into my life on countless levels, and I've got memories that I'll cherish forever. I could go on and on and on the things that you took part in pouring into me. Obviously, you made me a better basketball player, but just being able to look at you, study you, and see what kind of man you had become in the world of sports and competition helped me to model myself after that as well. And the way that you coach, and the way that you have passion, but that you have compassion as well. It's just something that I could go on forever, and I can't, I know, but I'm going to miss you guys. This is sad news, but it's good news. It's happy news at the same time, that I know that Lord has awesome plans in store for all of you. Miss Jamie, Micah, Chauncey, Bianca, I'm going to miss you guys so very much. I love having you guys in my life. I hate I wasn't able to be around very much the last couple of years, but man, excited for you guys. Let's keep in touch and continue to soar together. But man, love you. Can't say it enough how much you guys have been of value to me in my life. So God bless you guys, and hope to see you soon. Wherever the Lord takes you, hope to run into you and be able to catch up. All right, God bless.
Making a video like this is tough, because it means Coach Hall's not going to be with us next year, and that definitely sucks. But just the past 3 years I've got to spend with him has been such a blessing, and he's taught me so much. And just the little bit of time we've had together, whether it's, you know, leaving it better than you found it, having a victim mindset and blaming things on excuses and stuff like that, or having a growth mindset, always leaving room to grow in everything you do, whether that's like basketball, academics, spiritually, just knowing there's always room to grow in everything. We're definitely gonna miss Coach, Miss Jamie, the kids and everything, but you know, just cause they're going to do something else doesn't mean we won't be family. I'm excited to see them at my wedding one day. It's much love. I'm excited to see where him and his family goes, and the crazy impact they have wherever they go. Much love.
Hey Coach Hall, this is Kevin Cave, and I just wanted to send you a video saying thank you so much for being my coach for 3 different years, 2 different schools. It has been an incredible journey. My dream was always to play college basketball. I remember writing that on a paper in like second grade. And so my signing day, when you coming down to LCA, that's one of the best days of my life. And I remember everything about that day and just how good it felt. So thank you so much for investing in me, believing in me. And just through all 3 seasons, I saw how I matured, how I grew. I saw how much you matured and you grew in your spiritual walk and in basketball. And so I just want to thank you so much for everything you did for me, for investing in me. I learned so much about basketball than I would ever think is possible. And I'm going to continue to use the knowledge that you gave me in basketball as I continue my coaching career. You taught me so much about dedication, competitiveness, determination, never quitting. And I've applied that to a lot of aspects of my life, not just basketball. And another big thing that you taught me was preparation. I loved going into games and just feeling more prepared than the other team with the scouting reports that you would give us and with the game film that we would watch on other teams. So the preparation that we put into basketball, I love that, and I've tried to utilize that in other aspects of my life. So thank you so much for being my coach. I really enjoyed the 3 years. So many just fun memories that I'll never forget. But I think one of the most, probably the biggest thing that you taught me is something you never even said to me. And it was just with your family. Over the years, I got to watch you grow up, and I got to watch your kids really grow up. And just how you are as a father was so amazing to watch. Because you worked so hard for your kids, and you put so much love on your kids and your family. And just as I got to watch your kids grow up, they're so much fun and interactive, and just they're just so cool. And so to see how good of a father you are, I really appreciate that, and I loved seeing that. And those are definitely aspects that I'm going to try to utilize when I'm a father in the future. So thank you so much, Coach. I love you so much, and I appreciate everything you've done for me.
Hey, Coach Hall. I just wanted to make a video and kind of say thank you just for all the memories that, you know, we've made and all the things that you've done for me, and I know Jordan, the basketball team, just everybody. All the things you've done for us through these past, 3.5 years, I think. I'm just definitely grateful for that, and I want you to know that I will always take those memories with me, whether it's us, you know, sitting at your house, me, you, Miss Jamie, Jordan, till early in the morning, and talking about life and God and figuring out what the next step was, and crying, laughing, and doing everything in between. I'll definitely take those memories with me, and I believe that God sent you and your family to that school for such a time as that. Because I know before y'all came, I was personally struggling, and I wasn't sure whether Tocoa is where I should be. I didn't know what God wanted, all those things. And I believe that y'all were like a little family that God brought to me, and and Jordan as well. And you provided me with joy and understanding and a deeper relationship and a want for a deeper walk with God. So I know that it was God's will for you to come, and I can walk away after these 4 years and know that Tocoa is where God wanted me to be, and that we were all there for such a time as this. And I'll cherish those memories the rest of my life, and especially the laughs, any of the pranks we did, and y'all cracking eggs on my head, or Tyler trying to slam me in the bus, you know, slamming on the brakes first of all, or y'all scaring us. And then the cries, the laughs, and then even the times when you had to tell us, look, this is what you can improve on. This is what you need to do, but in a loving, fatherly way. And I just want you to know that I'll take those memories with me the rest of my life, and the words that you said, and I hope that you will as well. I hope you'll cherish our memories. And I hope that we continue to make new ones, and that we get to talk throughout these following years of college. But you were a huge blessing in my life, and I'll forever be grateful for that. So thank you, and I love you.